Are you interested in seeing what I used up this month, or do you just want to root around in my garbage with me? Hi, YouTube family. We're going to root around in my garbage. We're going to find out what I used up for the month. And these are all my product empties. And if it doesn't look like very much, it's because my last video that was product empties, I guess the camera wasn't on. And so I threw everything out thinking it was. The garbage went out. And then sure enough, I'm looking through my SD card the next day on my computer and there's nothing. So basically, I missed a month, but we're gonna make up for it here because I got a whole lot of stuff. So we're gonna talk about all this stuff that I used up so I can throw it away. Yay! Anyway, here we go. You guys, I used up this Eucerin Extremely Dry Rough Skin Roughness Relief Spot Treatment. It says it's dermatological skincare, and I believe it, you guys. This stuff, I put on my legs one night because I felt like they were super duper dry. I put it all over my legs, and it really is just a spot treatment, and I shouldn't have done that. And because my legs were so moisturized, they were like sticking to the sheets all night long, and it kept me up half the night. But if you have dry spot skin, like maybe you have psoriasis, maybe you have eczema, maybe, you know, you got a burn where that skin is really dry, this is really good. It's full of urea and ceramides. And I do think it's a really good cream for anybody that has roughness. Okay, we're going to go on to some hair care that I used. This is the Sun Bum 3-in-1 Leave-In Conditioner Detangler. And this smells so good, you guys. When I was using it, it was like, this is tropical beach type smell. It's even better, kid you not, even better than the Brazilian Boom Boom Cream, which everybody absolutely loves from Sol de Janeiro. I love this smell more. And will I repurchase this again? Probably if I can find it on a sale, because it was really good at detangling. I did feel like it really protected my hair from any heat or anything like that. So I probably would go ahead and buy that again if I had the chance to. I didn't realize I had so much hair care in this video. Okay, this is from Bumble and Bumble. This is the B6 Hairdresser's Invisible Oil Primer for your hair. This is a really, it's not an oil really, it's kind of a light milky substance. I spray it in my hand and then I rub my hand together and I just kind of put it all over my hair. It gave the prettiest shine to my hair, and it's really good at the heat and the UV protection too. That's why they call it a primer. I probably will go ahead and repurchase it, but you know, it's kind of pricey when you buy the bigger ones, but this was a sample, but it was a good one. Next is my Kenra 25 volume hairspray. This is my travel size that I took with me down to Mexico, and I absolutely love this spray, you guys. It is so good. I have used this for 15 plus years. It's one that I really have enjoyed having, and I will not be without that one in my bathroom. And the next one is my minoxidil. This is the extra strength, and it says it's for men. It's the 5%, and I say this every time I show this on camera. My dermatologist told me that this is just as good for women. It's just a little bit stronger, and I need something stronger because, as you guys know, I've lost so much hair, and I just really had to find something that worked really good, and this was it. So I buy this in a 3-pack and I get it off of Amazon, and it's not very expensive. I use this every single night. You're supposed to use it in morning and night, but I find that it can make my hair just a little bit greasy. And then I'm either going to be using dry shampoo or I'm going to be washing my hair the next day. So I do love this for hair growth. I'm really starting to notice a lot of little baby growth around my hairline, which makes me so happy. The next thing is also for hair growth. This was something I heard about on somebody's channel, and I can't remember whose channel it was, but this is shampoo and conditioner from Actiiv, the hair science for women, and this is called Recover Thickening Cleansing Treatment, and then this one is the thickening conditioner. Now, I really enjoyed these, both of them, but they're pricey, and I wanted to try them because I wanted to see if it was going to help stimulate my scalp and be able to help me a little bit more with my hair falling out. My hair has slowed down dramatically. I don't know what it is that's happening. I think that it's my weight loss has slowed down a little bit, so your hair can recover basically. But I liked these, but I don't think I'm going to repurchase them because I have been trying another one out, which I will show to you very shortly, that I think is just a little bit better than these. Yeah, I just think these are a little bit too pricey for not the payoff that I wanted. These right here are Tinkle Eyebrow razors, and they're just basically a straight razor that you get, and you can, you know, trim up between your eyebrows or underneath your eyebrows, whatever you need to do. But I use these for my dermaplaning or my actual face shaving. And that is going to be a video very soon for you guys. I'm going to do that on camera for you so that you can actually see. But these I get about 3 to 4 uses out of. I don't want to use them more than that because I do it a little bit deeper and get a little bit of exfoliating. And if after about 4 uses, they're at the point where they're not sharp enough to do that. They come in a pack of 3, and I usually get 4 to 6 packs depending on what kind of a deal they have then. But I really, really like these, and they're so much cheaper than the original ones. I used to buy them off of HSN, and they are just outrageously expensive. So this is really a great one, and I do repurchase those over and over again. Lumify. Have you guys tried Lumify yet? If you haven't, I want to tell you that this really does exactly what it claims. Your one drop in each eye and your eyes will be so bright. They will almost look like they're almost blue. The whites of your eyes will be that bright and that contrasted. And I just love it because on the days when I want to film, if my contacts are bothering me or anything, I'll put these in. Before I put my contacts in, you're supposed to wait 10 to 15 minutes and then you put your contacts in, but no redness for hours and hours. I don't use these every day because I am a contact lens wearer and I don't know the health of that. I have been told over and over again, even by my optometrist, that it's okay to use. And so I do use them a lot, but I don't use them every day. And yes, this is an absolute repurchase. And I'm going to repurchase the bigger one. I have another one that is the small one, but I'm going to repurchase the bigger one the next time I do because I love these things. And I just barely put in my monthly favorites, the X Lash Serum. This is an eyelash growth serum. And I have a big long spiel about this in that video. So I will link that video where I talk all about it, what it does, and this is an empty tube of it. So this is something that I repurchase at all the time and is in my empties, you know, every few months because I use it up. So definitely never be without that. I did get sent this NPR. This is Dermatology is the brand, the skincare brand, and this is their vitamin C complex. Okay, even though I like this, I have other vitamin C treatments that I feel like are a little bit more intensive. And I like to wear vitamin C because, as you know, it's that punch of antioxidant and that brightening that helps your skin so much. And so I'm probably not going to repurchase it. I didn't necessarily really love the way that it acted under makeup, so I ended up just using it just at night. But I kind of have other vitamin C's that I love a little bit more. And then also the Deer Skin, the Tranex Deer Serum from Deer Skin. And this has tranexamic acid, 5%. I heard about this from my friend Penny from Pensmith Skincare. If you guys are not on her channel learning all about skincare, you're really missing out because she has the best things to talk about on there. This is a lightening serum or brightening serum, and I really use this a ton on my chest. I have a lot of discoloration on my chest from years of sun damage and not wearing SPF, but this helped so much because my chest is usually always like 2 or 3 shades darker than my face and my neck. So I would recommend this. You can use it as a spot treatment or an all-over treatment. So if you have dark spots that you're wondering how to get rid of, this does help brighten those up. And it's anti-aging too, because it's going to help fade those. It's going to help make your skin look brighter, younger. So yeah, I really did like that. I will probably be repurchasing that one. And the next thing is from Algenist. This is called their Splash, and it's a hydrating setting spray. I did enjoy this, but I don't think I will repurchase it. For one reason is that I found another hydrating setting spray from the drugstore from Flower Beauty that I think is every bit as good. It's just lovely. I really do like it. And this one was just a little bit too pricey for me. So even though I tried this once and used it up, I feel like it's not something that I'm going to go run out and repurchase just because it has the higher end name on it, because I can get it at the drugstore at such a better discount. I also have one of my, I think this is apricot, not orange. Pretty sure it's apricot, of the Maybelline Master Camos. I loved these for such a long time, and I still think they're fantastic for people that have super dark circles. But for me, I have been noticing that, especially heading into menopause, dry skin weather with the winter and the dry air inside, this was a little bit too drying. So I switched over to the LA Girl correctors that come in the tube. And I've really been enjoying that because it's a little bit more moisturizing. So I do think as the summer comes, I will repurchase this because that's when you get a little bit more sweaty. So this is a little bit more drier and won't kind of, you know, mess up and break through. So I like both of them, but I'm not repurchasing that one right now. I like the other one right this second. This is from Essence. This is their Lash Princess Waterproof Mascara. This one I used up, it's all dried out now, but basically it just has the tree type stem right there, or wand, and I do like this. It builds up really well. I like it way better than any of the other Lash Princess ones because it is waterproof and it will stay on all day. But the one drawback to having the waterproof one is that it dries out a lot faster. So I wasn't able to feel like I was getting my money's worth, although your money's worth, give me a break. It's only like $5. But I would have liked it to last longer and not dried out so quickly. I used up this little mini of Sugar Sugar of Marc Jacobs lip gloss. And I do love his lip glosses. They have that little bit of the minty smell, or the smell that you get when you have kind of a little plumping lip gloss. Will I repurchase it? I probably won't, just simply because it's a bit too expensive for me, and I got this as a trial in a little kit that I had one time. And then the next thing is from Sukoyaka Suhara. This is their eye cream. I always cut mine in half to get every single drop out of it. You guys, this urea eye cream, I've said it a million times. I feel like I say this, I'm a broken record with this stuff. It's just the best stuff I've ever used. I've tried a bunch of different ones. I've never had anything hydrate those terrible, you know, crepiness underneath my eyes like this does. And I have noticed such a change in the way my makeup sits during the day and, you know, how crepey it gets and all of that good stuff. So I am a big believer in this brand and all of their products, but yes, I already repurchased this one and I'm already halfway through the new one. So that one I absolutely love, would say over and over again to repurchase. This is the Laneige Lip Sleeping Mask, and I really like this. But here again, even though I used it all up and I do feel like it's a really great product, it has a yummy smell, has kind of a berry smell, like a strawberry smell. But even though I really like it and I do recommend it, I don't feel like, because I am so dry right now and the weather is so dry. I sound like such a whiner when I'm saying all this, but I have dry heat that comes from the ceiling down on me. And so if I don't just like hydrate and just drench myself in the morning, I'm not gonna have any hydration. So I'm probably not gonna repurchase this for now. I might later on down the road, because I do think it's a fantastic product. Okay, that's it for today's video, you guys. I hope that you did enjoy seeing my empties, and now I get to go to the trash, which I like very much. Let me know in the comments section below if you guys use any of these products and what you think about them, or if you have products that you have purchased like this that are things that you just seem to go through the month really quickly because you love them so much. That's kind of what this is all about. I love watching empties, and I hope that you enjoyed watching mine. Please give it a big old thumbs up on your way out of here. I do appreciate that so very much. I hope everyone is well and staying warm in these winter months. I know some of you tune in from Australia and other places and you're going, it's hotter than the Dickens here. But I'm in very cold weather and lots of snow. So I hope everybody is warm. Take care of yourselves. I love y'all very much, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye, guys.